your problem anymore. So who am I offending now? You are my crime.
I said no one has to know what we do. Her hands are in my hair, her clothes are in my room, and her voice is a familiar sound. Nothing lasts forever, but this is getting good now. She's so tall and pretty as hell. She's so bad, but she does it so well. And when we've had our very last kiss, my last request is, say you remember me, standing in a nightdress, staring at the sunset, babe, red lips and rosy cheeks. Say you'll see me again, even if it's just in your wildest.
But I knew you'd linger like a tattoo kiss. I knew you'd haunt all over my what ifs. The smell of smoke would hang around this long. Cause I knew everything when I was young.
This is how the world works.
No, hate me,
me.
I mean, because there have been amazing people from my hometown, but I wasn't cool in school or anything. Like, I didn't have that many friends. Well, I did for a while, and then they didn't want to be friends with me anymore. So
I find that hard to believe.
Yeah,
but
it
like,
happens.
You know, it happens in middle school. People are mean to each other, and girls like say things about you behind your back, yeah, and then backstab yeah. you, and it's fun, all that good stuff. And so, like, I hadn't talked to these girls in a really long time, and you know, I didn't know how they felt about me or whatever. And after the show, I signed for everybody who showed up. It was a sold-out show, unbelievable show. My hometown has been great to me. And these girls who, like, you know, kind of ditched me in middle school, waited in line for hours with, like, T-shirts and pictures. And it was really, really sweet. It was unbelievable for them to just kind of forget about when we were kids.
See, if I were you, I would have been like, who are you?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
It would have been revenge time.
Oh, God. I can't ever be mean to anybody. Like, I just, like, it's like, I don't know.
I wish that you would. You've been out of reach. Could you explain? I think that you should. What you've been up to? Who has been loving you good? Hey, I'm the sun throwing up and down. Been looking through the depths and all the photos. Don't you worry, I can handle it. No, don't you worry, I can handle it. If you never.
There's a different vocabulary for men and women in the music industry, right?
Give me an example.
Okay. A man does something, it's strategic. A woman does the same thing, it's calculated. A man is allowed to react, a woman can only overreact.
Nice to meet you, where you been? I could show you incredible things.
Oh, hold on, hold on. Can we switch the language?
Knew he was a killer, first time that I saw him.
Hold on. Can we switch the language?
We could leave the Christmas lights up till January.
Hold on. Can we switch the language?
Green was the color of the grass where I used to read a centennial part. In my head, I don't know what to think. He knelt to the ground and pulled out a ring and said, marry me, Juliet, you never have to be alone.
You know, I see everyone out here talking about how both Harry and Taylor have done the piano under the water thing and how that connects. But y'all are forgetting the artist who walked so that those two could run. This is Ryan Evans' Erasure and I won't stand for it.
I'm drunk.
You showed me colors, you know.
was riding on my skateboard when I passed your house. Like I couldn't breathe.
So, okay, echo, pause. So it's gay, right? Like I'm not, this is a gay album. This is gay.
When you are young, they assume you know nothing. But I knew you'd linger like a tattoo kiss. I knew you'd haunt all over my world.
Oh Lord, save me, my drug.
Best comebacks in music history, part two. First, we have the one, the only, Taylor Swift. So 2016 was a really, really tough year for Taylor Swift. It all started when Kanye West put out a song where he said, "I feel like me and Taylor might still have sex. Why? I made that bitch famous." Rightfully, Taylor was pissed and said that she never gave consent for the lyric, "I made that bitch famous," to be in the song. And then Kimmy over here released a video where Taylor Swift was on a phone call with Kanye West, where Kanye West wasn't even giving the lyrics to Taylor. He was just saying, "Yeah, you know, I might throw a line in here about us having sex. Are you okay with that?" And then Taylor was like, "Yeah." Like, she was uncomfortable, clearly. But she definitely didn't give consent to the lyric, "I made that bitch famous." After this phone call leaked, everyone turned against Taylor. She was called a snake by the media. Her character was assassinated by the media. She was defamed. Someone in Melbourne even made a mural for Taylor Swift where it said, "In loving memory of Taylor, born in 1989, died in 2016. Like, what the f-? Anyway, Taylor, for her own mental health and well-being, went really silent and we didn't hear from her for a year or so. It was August the next year in 2017 when Taylor Swift was like, "Fuck it, let's embrace the snake." The next day she released Look What You Made Me Do, and it literally only took 10 minutes for it to reach number one on iTunes US. The video then blew up and broke Adele's record for the most views on YouTube in 24 hours. The song then became a global number one hit and Reputation was iconic. Like for part three.
Pulled up and said, "Get in the car," and then canceled my plan.